The Bangsamoro organic law.
What's the question?
Are you for it, against it? What are your concerns?
For?
Completely. Yeah. As is. Okay. Federalism.
Well, concerns probably the need for transparency in the
disbursement. Do you trust the MILF?
In the disbursement. The system has been in place. So we have to trust the system.
Okay. Federalism.
Yes.
Completely.
Yes.
Why?
As a former local official, just give you one example to really illustrate this. If a calamity strikes in Mindoro Oriental, they will have to get sardines and rice from DSWD Region 4B, which is located right in front of Paco Park in Manila. If they have to get vaccines for the Tigdas for Calapan, Mindoro Oriental, they get vaccines from Region 4B, Department of Health, Project 4, Quezon City, and so on and so forth.
Uh-oh.
So that's.
But won't devolution help alone? Do you need federalism for that?
Federalism probably would in effect, place the right offices and resources in places where they are needed.
Okay, but what about the argument of double taxation?
What do you mean double taxation? There's a taxation for federal government purposes would be different from taxation for local government purposes. It is happening right now. There's a national tax, there is a local tax. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's not double taxation.
All right, but okay, lowering the age of criminal liability?
I am in favor of that. But that has to be an age where the age of discretion would have to be really considered.
And what age is that? Because right now it's 15. That's the 2006 Juvenile Justice Act.
But which we just copied from other countries.
But they want to lower it to 12 now.
Yes. Australia, New Zealand, they've been always very vocal against human rights violations. They're silent now. Their age of criminal responsibility is 10. Indonesia is 8. Myanmar is 7. Hong Kong is 10. Singapore, I think, is 10. So, if you look at the other countries, what makes our youth different from theirs?
So, what do you think should it be then?
12, 13.
Okay.
12, 13.
So, 12, 13.
South Carolina in the United States is 6.
Yeah, but that's ridiculous. I mean, what does it mean to you when you say criminal responsibility? Let's say it's a 6-year-old. Or 10-year-old, how do you envision the implementation of the law?
I would give the child a legal term, diversion proceedings.
Okay.
If you're part of this, you get diverted into another court, and that the juvenile justice system would have to be applied. It would have to be different proceedings, different jail system. You don't mix them with hardened criminals.
Yeah.
It would only make them more criminals.
What are the realities? You were MMDA chief, and a lot of these children in conflict with the law live on the streets, right? You had MMDA traffic enforcers, seeing them every night, taking rugby, solvent, name it. How would you really solve that practically today? I mean, is the law the solution?
It's a social problem coming from poverty, but for purposes of this, we're dealing with crimes. We're dealing with the reformative justice system. How do you reform them in such a way that after finishing several years inside a penal institution, they can be reintegrated back to the mainstream society as reformed adults?
Okay. Medical marijuana.
I'm against.
Why?
It has not yet been scientifically proven that it is really working.
It's helped so many people with epilepsy.
That's what they said. And
yeah.
I know you will disagree with me. It's subject to abuse.
You're not smoking it. It's an oil.
It's subject to abuse. Although California and other states have ratified their state laws concerning this, others are vehemently against because it has not been yet scientifically, medically validated that it really alleviates your pain or what. I'm not kaibigan ko si Rodito, pero patunayan muna.
Okay. All right, the death penalty.
For heinous crimes,
Which are drug related all crimes. Heinous crimes?
Yes.
Okay. Oplan Tukang, how would you comment on that? I mean, you do have critics saying na ang namamatay lang puro nakachinelas.
2 weeks ago, there was a, in my home province in Cavite, there was an incident involving two Chinese in a big warehouse in Tansa, Cavite. So hindi naman siguro ganun. Yun lang yung na-highlight.
Mm-mm. So you support the president's
war on drugs?
For war on drugs.
Yes.
In every way.
A few minutes ago, we had your headlines, the Mexican drug cartel.
Bo, El Chapo.
Yes.
Bo.
So we don't need that El Chapo here in the Philippines.
But are we doing it the right way, the best way?
Ang na-highlight kasi is probably the lack of judicial intervention.
Bo.
But you've seen cases wherein policemen were convicted, investigated, prosecuted.
Yeah.
So the justice system is still working.
Okay.